Yo, what is going on, everybody? It is Grip and Rip Sports Cards back here with another video for you guys today. And in this video, we're going to be discussing probably one of the biggest Topps problems they have currently right now and how they could fix it with one simple, easy fix that they refuse to do for some reason. But before we get into that, thank you so much for joining me on this video. Can we get 100 likes on today's video? That is the like goal of today's video. 100 likes minimum would be great. That's the best way you can help me grow this channel is by hitting that like button. And speaking of growing the channel, we are doing a giveaway. We are giving away hobby packs of Series 2. All you got to do to enter is be subscribed, like this video, turn on the post notifications for all the content on the channel, and last but not least, leave a comment in the comment section on who your all-star representatives are on your favorite team, and I'll pick the winner once we hit 7,000. We're like literally like 5 away right now. So this is probably the last time, or next to last, I'm going to be announcing this giveaway. So make sure you got all the requirements. Make sure you subscribe. Make sure you have the post notifications on, which is that bell next to my name. Comment. Make sure you leave more than one, so that way I could actually see your comments, because I'm going to be reading all the video comments. So make sure that you're well known and well represented in the comments. So that way, of course, I accidentally don't pass up on you and don't skip over your name. When I am doing the reading for the comments. So there's that. And of course, Christmas merch is available now. We have a Black Friday sale going on right now that lasts all the way till Monday. If you use the code GNR for my initials, Grip and Rip, you'll get 20% off. So pretty freaking cool. Hopefully you guys like the Christmas merch. Probably my favorite designs I've ever done so far yet on the channel. And yeah, hopefully you guys enjoy the shirts just as much as I enjoyed making the designs, because I think they're really freaking cool. So let's get into it. So don't really want to waste a lot of your guys' time. I know you guys don't like longer videos, and you know, maybe that's a New Year's resolution. Maybe a New Year's resolution for the Grip and Rip channel is renovating the channel to a new look. Don't really know what I'm going to do yet. But I definitely know shorter videos are probably going to be a thing. Probably like 15-minute videos instead of 20. Because I know a lot of you guys are busy during the day, and a lot of you guys don't have 20 minutes to sit down and actually watch something. So I get it. I understand. Sometimes it's like that. You know, like today, I was shopping all day today. I literally probably watched like 5 minutes of YouTube content through all the favorite creators or the YouTube content creators that I like to watch. So I understand it, believe me, I understand that. We're going to have a new different format. We're going to have definitely a different format of how the videos are going to do. I'm probably going to show my face on a lot more of them, honestly. I don't know how exactly that's going to work just yet, but I think we're going to be definitely doing some more face cam videos. Maybe, I don't know. We'll have to wait and see. It could be done. We'll just have to see how it looks and how it does. And yeah, so let's get into the topic. Let's get into the topic at hand in today's video. Topps has issues, man. I mean, no doubt about it. Oh, yeah, before I even get any further with the commentary, I do want to say, out of all the stores I went to today, I will say this. I did not see a single box of Heritage, or not Heritage, but Archives or Crumb Update. Of course, Crumb Update blasters are not exclusive to Target. I saw pictures of them being found at Walmart. I don't know how. I thought they were exclusive to Target. I guess not, because someone posted on a Facebook group they're at Walmart. So yeah, I literally didn't see anything worth buying today with cards. All I bought was a pair of shoes, Funko Pop, and Lego Star Wars Skywalker Saga that was $15 at Walmart. So I really didn't buy too many things today in terms of toys or cards, because there really wasn't much. Target, I went to Target today. I went to a Walmart. Filled to the gills of everything but Holiday, Chrome Update, and Archives. Allen and Ginter, out the wall zoo. I did see Bowman. That's a fun fact. I took a picture to use for another time when we talk about retail sports cards. I saw some Bowman blasters. I probably should have picked them up. I'm kind of kicking myself for not doing it. I do actually want to pick up some more of them. I should have probably done that. But for $30, I mean, I could have definitely done them. But honestly, I want to buy some more Chrome. I do want to buy more Chrome. Not Chrome Update, regular Chrome. Because, of course, the buybacks, and if you get the buybacks, you could use it for draft in a couple weeks, which we'll be talking about draft in this video. So yeah, I don't know. We'll have to wait and see. I really haven't seen too much Chrome either because obviously it's getting all bought up for the buybacks and stuff. So that's going to be hard to find now going forward. Unless you buy it online, you should be able to find it online pretty easily. But yeah, let's get to the topic at hand. You know, I kind of alluded to this yesterday and we'll go in more in depth with it today because I think it is worth a full discussion video. You know, we're about, let's see, today's the 25th. We have about what? I don't even know how many days there even are in November. I think 30. So we're about 6 days away or so from December. And with that, we're about additional 2 weeks after that for draft. Draft comes out December 13th, which, of course, draft is going to be pretty popular. I mean, there is no doubt about it. I mean, Paul Skeens, I don't even know the other guys, Max Clark, I believe, is it Wyatt Langford? I think it's Wyatt Langford who's in there as well. I got him and the Twins guy mixed up. So yeah, I think it's Wyatt Langford's in the set. Those are the top three you're going to want to chase for. But that's not the issue. I mean, draft's going to be great. There is no reason to complain about draft yet until the until we see some quality control issues, which I can guarantee you we're definitely going to see. I promise you we're going to see it. We're not going to talk about that right now. We're going to talk about some other things. And what I just cannot stand with, I cannot absolutely just stand what Topps is doing right now. And that is with the other sets that come out in December. So in case you guys didn't watch yesterday's video, which again, I don't blame you because you're probably all off shop and you probably didn't even know I uploaded a video. But either way, we have we have three different top sets that all come out on the same day. On top of that, I also want to mention, there are multiple other sets that come out that same day with other companies. For example, I saw this because I actually have interest in this. The Spider-Man No Way Home Upper Deck set, which I assume there's going to be blasters and a hobby format for that. I'm a big Spider-Man guy. I love Spider-Man. No Way Home is my favorite Spider-Man movie of all time. Having all three live-action Spider-Men in one film, I mean, what more can you ask for, right? But either way, that set comes out December 13th as well. So there is a ton. You can go view the schedule right now on Cardboard Connection if you really want to see the whole schedule. But there is a ton of Leaf, Upper Deck, Panini, and Topps products all on December 13th. I do not know why. I think it's kind of ridiculous if you ask me personally. But, you know, I just don't agree with it. I do not agree with it. I get Christmas is coming up. I get that these companies want to make every single penny they can so that way they can gloat to their investors. Oh, yeah, quarter four of 2023 made this much profit, right? I get it. I understand that. But look at it with the consumers in mind because Topps, I don't think, does. And we could use Leaf, Upper Deck, and Panini for that matter as well because, like I said, there are countless sets that come out December 13th. I don't know why. I think it's ridiculous because at the end of the day, let's ask ourselves this question. How many of you guys, let's say, want to buy draft, which everyone's going to want to buy draft, so let's throw draft into the equation, right? How about you want to buy some Spider-Man No Way Home, which I know definitely piques people's interest, piques my interest. I'll probably wait for blasters of that. I'm not going to buy a hobby. I'm just going to buy maybe one or two blasters and to see what it is all about, and we'll have fun with it, right? Another set, Topps Chrome Black. I know that set is pretty popular. You know, it's like, I think like 120. That's how much it was, I believe, last year, like 120 or 130. That set, you know, is fairly popular. You don't get much for what you pay for, but you get an autograph in a one-touch, nonetheless, so that's pretty cool, right? And then there is Plain Jane Heritage High Number. I mean, I'll tell you one thing. If the interest of this set is reflected by how many views I got on yesterday's video, I'll tell you right now, nobody cares for Plain Jane Heritage High Number. I expected that. I mean, I knew, like, here's the thing. I can tell, based off of my view counts for which product, how much people care about the product. Like, for example, Chrome Update, my videos did great, right? Because obviously, interest for that set was really high, right? I can guarantee you draft, like last year, my views for draft were insane, right? Draft, gonna be insane for views, right? That's just how it's gonna be. Plain Jane Heritage High Number, down the gutter. As I figured it would be, because honestly, Nobody cares. Nobody cares. And I do think, I will tell you this right now, I'm going to make a prediction. I guarantee this is going to come true. Toph is probably going to cut some more dead weight next year. So you know how they canceled Fire, Gypsy Queen. I still don't know why they did that. Gallery, right? Those sets. I think next year, they're going to cut more dead weight. And honestly, I'll tell you right now, I think they're going to merge Heritage and Heritage High Number into one set and call it Heritage from this point on. Because there is no reason to have two Heritage sets. I get this new Heritage set. I understand it. It's basically the update of Heritage. That's all it is, right? But I do think down the line, with how they have kind of switched this schedule around. So they, you know, up until this year, Heritage used to come out in March. But for whatever reason, from this point on, Heritage came out in like late May this year for some reason. I don't know what that was about. But Heritage High Number back in the day used to come out in August. Now it comes out in December. I think they should merge the sets, call them Heritage, and release it some point in September or something like that, and call it a day with the update rookies and everything like that, and call it a day, right? I do not like the current format. I definitely think with how many products they make nowadays, like with the higher-end stuff, and Garbage Pail Kids or whatever, and Star Wars, and eventually WWE football and basketball all joining the companies that are going to be on Tops, which we all know is coming down the line sooner rather than later. Tops is going to have to cut dead weight. They're not going to be able to produce all of these different sets in a timely manner. I mean, look at how many times they're struggling to put out sets today. How many times this year have we talked about, oh yeah, this set got delayed. This set got delayed. This set got delayed 8 weeks. This set got delayed 4 months, like Stadium Club did, right? So Tops is definitely going to be cutting dead weight. I can guarantee it. I don't know when. It could be next year. We saw it happen this year with Gypsy Queen, which I do not know why they canceled that set. That set actually sold well. I do not know why Allen and Ginter is still a thing. Allen and Ginter, I'll tell you right now, should be reduced. If they want to release Allen and Ginter next year, I'll tell you how they should do it. They should reduce it to a Tops Online exclusive. No retail, no hobby format. Put, you know, the hobby boxes on Tops.com. And if hobby stores want to carry them, have at it. But they should definitely be reducing the amount of product they make for that set. Do you know how many blaster boxes I saw today of that product? From all the stores I went to, I'm going to take a guess about at least 40 plus. And I'm not even joking. Target, the one Target I went to, had just an insurmountable amount of them. I went to a Lids, you know, a hat store. The amount of Gypsy Queen I saw there, or not, I wish Gypsy Queen. Allen and Ginter, I meant. The amount of Allen and Ginter I saw there, pathetic, as well as 2022 Top Series 1, by the way. They can't even sell that, which, go figure, with how bad the set is now with that player in that set that don't mean crap no more. Yeah, 2022 Top Series 1 is pointless, to say the least. But either way, what I'm saying here, Tops has an absolute problem on their hands. I mean, I don't know what they're going to have to do to fix this. This might be a complicated... This might be a very complicated fix for all I know. But I'll tell you one thing. I'll tell you one thing for a damn fact, right? Releasing sets all on the same day, like they are doing December 13th, which they have done countless other times this year, is pathetic. It's pathetic because us, the consumer, deserve better. If we want to go out there and buy all these sets, chances are, in December, with Christmas right around the corner, and people buying gifts and everything like that, chances are, if you want to buy all this stuff just for you to open up, just for yourself, you're not going to be able to do that. You're just not going to be able to do that. Because Tops puts us in a corner. They literally cornered us right now. Like, you have to pick a set. You know, it's ridiculous. Like, I would love to open 2023 Tops Chrome Black. I actually said to myself last year, maybe I want to do that next year. Just to give it a try and see what it is. It's a one video thing. It's not for like, you know, it's one pack and one encased autograph. So it's not like an actual hobby box, but it's still something to open. I said to myself last year, man, maybe we should do that on the channel next year and see what it's all about. But, I mean, When draft comes out the same day, I mean, what set do you think I'm going to choose? I mean, draft in 10 out of 10 days. Same thing with Heritage High Number, Plain Jane Heritage High Number. I mean, I would love to have Plain Jane Heritage High Number in the collection. I don't think the checklist is that good. They haven't released it yet, but I'll tell you right now, all of these Series 1 and 2 rookies are in normal Heritage, except Walker and Volpe, which they made short prints for some reason in that set. So, I don't really think Heritage High Number is going to be that good. I might just buy my Pirates in a team set on eBay, because I'm probably going to use them for Pirates Fest. Pirates Fest is January 6th, and those cards, those Heritage cards, look nice autographed, because they have a nice, white background, or a lighter background to sign on, right? So, I'll probably do that. I don't know who's in the checklist. I don't even know if a checklist is even out yet for that set. But either way, I would love to open that stuff. But here's the thing. Here's the thing. Again, why would I do that when draft comes out the same day? It makes no sense. They literally, like, as a content creator, it sucks. Now, as a collector, it sucks even more. It sucks as a content creator because, of course, as you guys know, I like to do a pack a day, right? I like to conservatively, spread out the packs and open one a day. So that way, because here's the thing, these boxes add up quick. I mean, as you guys are well aware from yourself buying boxes as well, you guys know, these boxes add up quick when you buy these products. And I open a pack a day, and 95% of what I open is hobby product. So, you know, I spend a lot of money every year on cards. Next year, I will tell you, a New Year's resolution of mine is to stop spending a lot of money on cards. Like, I'm definitely going to be stopping a lot of collecting of different sets. Like, Heritage next year, I'll buy my Pirates team set. I don't think I'm going to open Heritage. I already stopped opening Allen and Ginter. I stopped that this year. So, I'm really going to start honing in on what I want to collect. Like, for example, Series 1 next year should be pretty good. I'll buy that. Chrome next year with Series 1 and 2 rookies, that should be very good. Chrome next year, you're going to want to buy a lot of. I'm probably going to end up buying, I mean, I don't know how many hobby boxes I'll end up buying, depending on the price. But I'm definitely at least going to buy probably $300 worth of Chrome product next year. Don't know how, with how different formats and everything like that. But either way, to wrap this video up, as a content creator and a collector myself, it sucks. Because I like to open different things. But when they release all these different sets in like a span of like a couple weeks or a day like we're seeing here, you know, Topps is known to do this now. If you guys have been catching on to the scheme they have been doing, they release in clusters for some reason. Like, a couple weeks, you'll have a couple sets. And then you'll go 2 months without a set. Like, for example, we went from Series 2 in June to Chrome in late July. No sets in between that. That's like 7 weeks without a singular Topps product. But then Topps had the absolute nerve to release 3 sets in one day. You see where the issue is here. And don't mind me, I'm opening up this box here in the background. You see where the issue is here. I just don't get it. I truly, truly, truly don't understand what has to happen. But something has to change. I mean, Topps, I know you like to watch my stuff. I know some employees have watched my stuff in the past, and I probably think they still do. Listen, something's got to change. As collectors, and I'm sure you guys, some of you guys at least, are collectors yourselves. Like, I mean, the writing is on the wall. I mean, I don't know what else to say. The writing is definitely, definitely, definitely on the wall, because it just doesn't make any sense. You know, Topps, you know, by you doing what you're doing on December 13th, you are actively rooting for Heritage High Number to fail. It's going to fail. I mean, no one in their right mind is going to a hobby store on December 13th thinking to themselves, yeah, I'm buying Heritage High Number. No. When they see packed a draft in front of their face, I mean, the writing is on the wall. I mean, it's seriously, it's so bad. It's seriously, just so bad. I mean, I don't know. So either way, we're going to finally open this box of Chrome Update. Finally getting to it. Of course, as you guys know, we've been opening random loose packs from the hobby store this whole time. Now getting into the actual box itself. I don't know when we're going to finish it, because come December 1st, when that clock strikes 12, December 1st, we're going to be opening holiday for the whole month of December. So Most likely, I hope I don't pull the autograph, or I should say I hope I do, before December 1st, or else we're going to have a lot of time to wait before I pull that autograph in this box. So hopefully I pull the autograph before December 1st, but I don't think I'm going to. I'm literally going to be opening, like, what, 5 packs out of this, out of the 24, so the chances of us pulling an autograph is pretty unlikely, but you never know. I mean, you never know. So we have Matt Mervis. We have two refractors here. So we have Matt Mervis. We'll go from the back. Adam Duvall. We got a X-Fractor Prism, I believe this is, of Heimer Candelario. Not the best one in the world you're going to want, but, you know, still one nonetheless. And we got an 88, right, of Riley Green. Man, I'll tell you, man, we have been pulling some great 88s. If you guys missed yesterday's video, we pulled this 88 as well, Gunnar Henderson. So we have really, really, really been showing up with the 88s. I will say that. The 88s we have pulled have been very good. I don't know the checklist for the 88s in the set, but either way, they've been pretty good. And we pulled, of course, if you guys missed this video just a couple days ago, we pulled a Volpe Prism X-Fractor, whatever this is called. I don't know. We pulled one of those as well. So I will say this. My crumb update luck so far, knocking on wood, has been very good. It's been very good so far. We'll have to wait and see how that ends up with the autograph we pull in box two. So we'll have to wait and see. But I'll tell you one thing: the refractors and the parallels we have pulled, inserts of rookies, have been pretty good. So let's keep the train rolling, and we'll have to. Maybe we'll buy some more, you know? Maybe we'll buy some more of this stuff. I don't know. We'll have to wait and see. I definitely do want to buy a blaster box just to see what it's all about. I heard they're absolutely garbage. I don't know why I'm even going to waste $35 on one, but I just want to try it out and see what actually happens. So, guys, I'm getting out of here. Let me know what you think about this huge problem. I mean, let's do a poll. If you had to buy one set, answer this in the comment section. If you had to buy one set on December 13th, what are you buying? Draft? Chrome Black or Heritage High Number? I'd love to hear what you guys have to think. I already know what the answers are going to be, but let's just do a social experiment. Either way, I'm getting out of here. Let me know what you think, and I'll see you guys in the next video.